This is a quick update on the service concept that I have been covering for quite some time. You might be already aware that we have created two apps. In the one app, I have implemented the code to start a service, and on click of that particular start service, basically the random numbers are getting generated. On the other app, the client side binder app, I bind to a service and I get a random number and I can unbind it. My application, which is trying to bind to this particular service, that is client side main activity, it will connect to that particular service by knowing the complete package name of the service and the fully qualified name of the service. And my other app, which has a service, will directly connect it. There could be a small issue here. It would be a good idea to make sure that only proper application gets connected to this particular service. What you have to do inside the onBind method is, instead of directly returning iBinder, that is messenger.getBinder, do a small check that what is the package name. What I am actually checking is whether the expected package name, that is the name of the app, the client app, is matching or not. So if you go back here, client side main activity and the manifest file, I am checking that whether this particular package name is getting connected or not. What you have to do is go to the client and then say service intent dot set package. You can do here get package name. This will set the package, and on the service side, I will check whether that is the same package name I am getting or not. If I am getting, then I will allow it to connect to this particular service. You can see that I am toasting a message, correct package. So let me run this code. I will start the service, I will go to the client app, and when I bind to the service, you will see correct package, because that is a toast message, and then service is bound. So this is one way of securing a service so that any application should not connect to your service. So that is one precaution. There are many other ways, but this is one of the simpler way. Another thing that I wanted to talk here is, from Android Lollipop version above, Android has stopped supporting implicit way of starting a service. What I mean by that is, if you go back to my activity here, I am setting the component name and package name. Now there is another way which used to be supported in the Android for starting a service, which was implicit. That is, in the manifest file of the service, what I would have done is I would have created a intent filter and then action. You can give any sample action value, and you can give even the category. We will use default category. And then going back to the client, what I would have done is I would have set those action and category to the service intent. And let me go back to my service here. To make it simple, I will directly return it. And now let me run the code. Start service, go to the client app and try to bind. The application will fail. And if you see what is the problem, you will see that service must be explicit. So if some of you have been getting this error where service is not getting started and you get the error saying that it must be explicit, basically that means probably you are working with the old way of doing things of starting a service. So always use explicit intent while starting a service. That's all with this particular video. Happy coding, take care, bye, and don't forget to like, comment, share and subscribe to the channel.